Hello and a happy welcome to episode number 15 of Eliphas Leary's lectures about magic. In this episode I want to talk a little bit about invocation and evocation. Both are techniques to work with spirits, deities, demons, let's just say beings that do not have a body. If they ever had a body, or if they ever will have a body, that's a question that someone else should answer, or try to answer. I think many people already did try to answer that. No matter if you believe their answers or not, make up your own mind. Well, what do they have in common? What separates them? First of all, invocation and evocation, well, at least the invocation is always a form of possession by a spirit, by a deity, by a being. The evocation, not necessarily. Can be a combined work where one person is evoking and the other person is invoking, but that's a difficult matter and a different topic. Well, the preparations for both are pretty much the same. No matter if you want to perform an invocation or an evocation, for both you prepare yourself in the way that you gather knowledge about the being you want to invoke or evoke, the being you want to summon. This knowledge should be, well, it should be almost everything that you can get access to. And especially in older pantheons, as for example the Egyptian pantheon, you'll always find some beings where different stories are told about that being. Sometimes these different stories even contradict each other, but they are all stories about the same being. So they all tell you something about that special being. So don't let the contradictions irritate you. Just gather the knowledge. That's the most important part. Sometimes these contradictions explain themselves while you study, and so they start to make sense, even if they still remain contradictions. But well, that's the funny thing about gods. The invocation, if successful at the highest degree, results in a complete possession of the magician, including all the things like amnesia and maybe extraordinary powers, like for example the ability to use the muscles in a way that a normal human being wouldn't be able to, or other things like that. Sometimes it's quite useful to have some friends, some colleagues with you when you want to perform such such an intensive invocation, because these results of amnesia and complete possession and the like, they can be very dangerous, and these assistants, friends, colleagues, they should be able at least to perform proper banishment. For example, the pentagram rites or stuff like that. And, well, to come to the evocation, and in my humble opinion, the invocation is something like the necessary prerequisite for the evocation. You can't evoke something that you haven't invoked at least once. You see, in the invocation, you experience an aspect of yourself as something like a god, or something that is relative to a god, related to a god. In the evocation, you have to come to a point where you externalize this part of your own being. Well, this part of your own being has to come from somewhere, and everything that is inside of you comes from somewhere outside of you. So this aspect that some gods might personify, these aspects come from outside. They are outside of you somewhere. And during an evocation, you try to externalize that aspect. And you, by that externalization, you try to forget it, try to forget that you have any relation to that. And you try to forget it to an extent that this quality, the quality of that being, outside of you becomes like a stranger. And I think that's a good point to say that an evocation is kind of successful. When you really meet the force that you evoked as something completely strange to you. And maybe depends on the way you're working in, and on the way how much you work with your body, that can manifest even more things than just some slight qualities of some being. Well, read the literature like Peter Carroll, Aleister Crowley, if you can get Gregor or Gregorius, there you might find a lot more interesting stuff about invocation and evocation. I hope this was a little help. Hope this got some people out there some new inspiration, some new insights, or some new ideas. Hopefully something new. Next episode will be about, what will it be about? The evolution of the gods, I'll call it. So it will be a little bit about the advancements of magic in the 20th century and what happened in the 20th century. Hope you enjoyed this, hope you stay tuned, see you soon, and enjoy yourself.